So, something big just happened. It's about the Italian Democratic Party. The Democratic Party is the biggest left-wing party in Italy and the second biggest nationwide. It has a long and detailed history that I just cannot get into right now, but I might soon if this video gets 30 likes. Its party secretary Nicola Zingaretti resigned last week, almost out of the blue. And as I'm writing this, the new party secretary has been chosen and will become official in a few days from now. The lucky man is Enrico Letta, who was prime minister from 2013 to 2014. Before I tell you more about Letta, I need to get into what is happening in the PD right now and what brought Zingaretti to kick the bucket. The Democratic Party has been a mess ever since the Five Star Movement and the right-wing coalition won the 2018 elections. This sense of disorientation was worsened by the fact that the party secretary Renzi also resigned and made his own party. Zingaretti was his successor, and despite the fact that he had a pretty good reputation, he found it very hard from the beginning to lead the party due to the new currents that had formed. The first current is the social democratic current, with people like Orlando, current minister of employment, Gualtieri, former minister of economics, and Boldrini, former president of the Chamber of Deputies. Then we have the centrists, with people like Franceschini, minister of culture, Pinotti, former minister of defense, and Fassino, former mayor of Turin. Finally, we have the social liberals, the remnants of Renzi's inner faction, in PD. Its members are former prime minister Gentiloni, former minister of defense Guerini, and Bonaccini, current president of Emilia-Romagna. Keep in mind that most of these currents have their own little subcurrents, and I have a headache. Zingaretti was sick and tired of these currents fighting all the fucking time about dumb shit, and he was tired of not being able to do much as secretary of the Democratic Party due to these inner fights. Zingaretti is also the president of the region of Lazio, which is kind of a mess, so one day he probably woke up and realized, yeah, I have to pick one, and here we are today. Now, let's talk about Letta. Enrico Letta comes from a family of important people. His father was a mathematician, his uncle was Berlusconi's right-hand man in 1994, and one of his cousins is the director of Medusa Films. Despite his connections, he is far from a daddy's boy. He has a very good reputation, solid curriculum, and a long history in the Democratic Party. He was minister under D'Alema and Prodi, and was Bersani's right-hand man from 2009 to 2013. When he became prime minister, the parliament was having a hard time making decisions since the Five Star Movement was somehow able to win a sizable portion of the seats, and suddenly the average IQ of the Chamber of Deputies dropped of 20 points. Letta, being the respectable centrist man that he was assigned by president at the time, Napolitano, to make a new cabinet, and he did, while also winning the vote of confidence of most of the parties. Sadly, his government lasted just about 10 months due to the slow progress of his economic reform and Renzi. But now it's 2021 and Renzi is gone from the Democratic Party, which needs stability more than ever. Franceschini was the first to ask Letta to come back, followed by many other politicians. And after thinking about it, Letta decided to accept the challenge at the condition that he will stay there up until 2023, the time when the new elections are scheduled. Letta is a very pragmatic politician, which is a rare sight these days. Charm is not his specialty. That's why he was so easily dethroned by Renzi 7 years ago. But he is a man that inspires trust, and I hope he will be able to use his experience and knowledge to make the Democratic Party a force to be reckoned with at the next election. Now, the mic goes on to you, figuratively speaking. Write in the comments below what you think about Letta. And also like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. I will see you next time with a brand new video. See you next time.